So once we have our sales tab filled out, obviously we're going to go across to the build phase and add some costs in here, some construction costs. Firstly, there's going to be the preliminary cost. So you can put in here any of the preliminary costs that you believe your project is going to incur. You can add as many preliminary costs as you like, and obviously get rid of these if you like as well. Then we move into the main build phase. So we're going to continue with our townhouse build cost here. And then you're going to see this automatically filled in 2,210 square meters. Now this is pulling the total area from our sales tab. But remember that we had a retail and a townhouse construction. So we're going to break them out as an example. So here, the townhouses were 210 square meters, and you're going to see this gross area here based on 120%. Now with townhouses, that's probably going to be more closer to 100%. And we can add in build costs here. So this build cost can be done on a per square meter basis. So again, we're going to put in our townhouse build cost, and we're going to say maybe we can get away with $2,500 per square meter for our townhouse build. Down here, you're going to see the contingency. We've added in 10% contingency. Maybe you're confident you want to change that to 5. And there you can see our townhouse build cost summarized at the bottom. We can add a second phase here, and we can call this retail. You can see the 200 square meters remaining. Click apply. Maybe this is built at 110% of the NIA to get our gross. Again, we're going to go retail here, and this should be a lot cheaper, so maybe 1800 per square meter with, as a small development, 5% contingency again. So here we can see all of our build cost, and down the bottom all of those prices summarized, and keeping an eye on the right hand side as our key metrics get further and further updated as we put in more and more data.